Hello everyone, in this video we are going to study about how we are going to design the strainer tubule. So there are certain parameters whose values need to be determined if you want to design such type of tubules. Let's say if you want to design such type of tubules, then we need to know what is the size of the tube, what should be the appropriate size of the borehole, similarly what should be the length of the strainer as well as the type, and similarly the horsepower of the pumping arrangement which is required in order to extract the water. So if you want to design such type of strainer tubule, so these criteria, these designing steps we must follow, and we must individually try to know each of these values, and then only we can design the strainer tube well. So first is the size of the tube. So what should be the size of the tube that should be required in order to just extract the water? So there are certain criteria which is given. Let's say the size of the tube can be less at the top or more at the bottom, depending upon the flow of the velocity. But such type of permissions are not allowed because we can't have a tube of varying sizes. So that is a type of limitation that you can see over the size of the tube. So what could be the other alternative? Since it has been also said that we have to limit the velocity of the water through this tube to be between 1.5 to 4.5 meter per second. So if you know the discharge of this tubule and this velocity, then we can work out on the area of the tube, and we can hence determine the diameter, which can easily be calculated via this. So by if we use this method, then we can know the what should be the size of this tube. Similarly, if you want to know the size of the borehole, then it is being suggested that this borehole should be at least 5 cm bigger than the size of this tube, and this helps in the facilitation of the lowering down of the tube, and also this extra gap is filled by the gravel packing, which further helps in the filtering of all the impurities which comes in the bore well. Now next is the length of the strainer. So in order to calculate the length of the strainer, we will use the equation for the discharge of unconfined and the for confined aquifer case, and from there we will determine the value of the length of the strainer. So let us suppose that this is the equation given by the Dupitz for the unconfined aquifer. So from here we can replace this D minus HW by S, that is the drawdown. Okay, and when we expand this value D square minus H square W, then it is like this, and similarly we will replace this at D minus HW by S, and then we will do certain modification and we will take the value of HW, and this HW is basically representing here the length of the strainer. And in this equation, this you can see this RW is the radius of the well. Simultaneously this capital R is the radius of the influence, and if you don't know, then we can take its value between 250 to 500 meter. Similarly, the value of the coefficient of permeability is also can be also assumed depending upon the type of this well. So if you work out on all these values, we can easily get the length of the strainer that we can use for the design purpose. Next, if you are having a confined aquifer, then we will use this formula, and from where we can get the value of H, which is equals to the length of the strainer, and that can easily calculated by the help of this equation if we know all the unknown quantities. Hence this design is strainer length that is needed to be provided in one or more aquifer, and obviously that depends upon the site availability. Okay, so we will conclude till here, and in our next video we will look into the last designing criteria, which is the pumping arrangement, which is essential for in order to extract the water from far below the level of the surface of the earth. Okay, thank you.